In Britain and in Germany, it's 12 noon. So at home and away, once again, it's time for two-way family favourites.
The voice of Jean Metcalf introducing today's family favourites. And Jean, together with her husband Cliff Mitchell-Moore, has joined me in London here today. Welcome, very, very welcome, both of you. Delighted to see you. Must be a bit like coming home, Jean.
But it's lovely to meet you after all those years, because you used to be in Malta, didn't you?
Yes, many years ago.
We used to talk to each other.
And I think, can I introduce you to our two other compatriots, Michael Baggerly in Belfast. How are you, Mike?
Hello, Sandy, and a very good afternoon, Jean.
Hello, Michael.
Makes me feel very sentimental, this. Way back, 52, it was 52 or 53, I can't remember, I have a terrible memory for dates, that I did do a few of the programmes with you, actually, on the other end.
I remember that. Well.
Oh, marvellous.
And I don't think you need any introduction to Cliff, do you, Michael, since you worked together?
No, we didn't actually work together. I think I didn't arrive until 50, I think it wasn't Cliff, had just disappeared.
I was just going at the time.
Ah.
There wasn't room for both of us there, I worked out.
Thank you.
However, Cliff, you have met, I know, Andrew Pastuna in Cologne.
Yes, he once came and interviewed me.
That's right. I was just saying I can always smell the roast beef and Yorkshire pudding. How about that?
Andrew, you've not yet met Jean.
Well, in fact, we did meet at our house in Redhill, I think, about 5 years ago, and seeing both children off to swimming. I can recollect that.
Good gracious, you've got a better memory than I have, Andrew. We hope both children are getting their lunch at this moment now. They're not children anymore.
No, they're not.
Now then, it's going to be a bit crowded, all five of us here together. Andrew and Michael, I'm sure you won't mind if we take the first record here. And Jean, how about you starting us off?
Love to. Yes, I've got a card here. And we're asked to play a record for Warrant Officer Harry Eggbeer, who's just returned to Germany for his third spell of duty, it says. The card, Harry, comes from your parents, Mr. and Mrs. Eggbeer, of Higher Roborough, I think it is, Ashburton in Devon, and it brings you also love from your sisters, Valerie, Lynn and Pam, and your brothers, John and Fred, and your sisters and brother-in-law, and your 12 nephews and nieces. What an expensive Christmas in that family. Lots of love anyway, Harry, from everyone at home.
And Cliff.
The first thing I notice is it costs you sevenpence to send a postcard these days. Change from the halfpenny or penny in our day. This is to Sergeant John Dumphy with the 2nd Battalion of the Light Infantry in Lemgo. This is from your wife, Pat, your daughter, Heather. They're both very sorry not to have been able to spend your birthday with you, but they look forward to seeing you in November, or December, Let's hope the ? Are rubbed out and you do meet very soon.
And here's one from the Prince family of Pasture Avenue, Morton, Wirral in Merseyside. They have two sons away in Germany. Phil is with the army in Minden, along with his wife Isabel. Tony and his wife Jean are at RAF Bruggen. They're both living in married quarters there. Tony's two children are Tracy, who's 9, and Tony, who's 7. And Phil's little girl, Angela, was 4 years old on the 3rd of October. Lots of love from all the family, who miss you very much and are looking forward to seeing you at the end of the year. And our first piece of music is one that we played on the very first Family Favourites on the 7th of October 1945. Glenn Miller, I Know Why.
Thank you.
Bringing out those goose pimples, Glenn Miller with vocal refrain and his orchestra, and I know why. And in fact, I do know now why Gene and Cliff never did talkovers, because I reckon it would take about a minute to get into the talkover on that one, wouldn't it? Well, I think here's a place that you'll certainly know, Cliff, and that's RAF Gato up in BFP 45, which
very
is
well.
Berlin. You once told me a very good story about doing a commentary from Berlin and being banned from the BBC-like programme for doing it, eh?
That's quite right. Absolutely right.
Right, Josie and Brian Richards, they're not banned from Berlin. They've dropped me a line to say, please could we have a request on Family Favourites on the 5th of October. It's for Mum and Dad, Roger and Geraldine, Karen and Robert, who live at Alexander Road, Bridgewater and Somerset. And please tell them we look forward to seeing them at Christmas time. Also mentioned for Mrs. Marion Richards and Glyn, who we hope got home safely after staying with us in Berlin for 2 weeks. Could you also wish my husband Brian a happy birthday for today? He's 21... but we think that's his neck measurement. Thank you very much indeed, Josie and Brian Richards. And to this card, oddly enough, to a place I visited only 2 days ago. That's Detachment 15 COD Versen Workshops, REME BFPO 40, and on the front is a postcard of Mönchengladbach. Please play a record on your link for all our relatives and friends, especially Mum and Dad, Mr. and Mrs. Robert Love, of Lake Hill, Lake Isle of Wight. I've never read out a request for the Isle of Wight before. Also, Pat...
It's just down the road from where we've got a house in Bembridge, I'll tell you. We know Lake very well.
You've got two houses now. Mm. My goodness, the shekels must be railing in. Also, Pat, Eric and family, Iris and Bill, June, Spencer and boys, Avril, Peter and boys, Ron, Eve, Linda, Alan, Alan, Brian and Beverly, and also Pam, Charlie and children. This comes from Ray and Gary Hodson of BFP 40. So to the record, and it comes from Bobby Goldsborough. The title is I Wrote a Song.
I once heard it said, if someone would write a song, that the world could sing along, the world might be in harmony. So I wrote a song, the kind of song you sing along with, and the words are very simple, la la la. It has a style to make you smile, and all the while, the only words you have to sing are la la la. And if you sing, you'll find it brings a lot of things, the kind of things that might make people get along. So what's to lose? Let's spread the news. Don't refuse now, everybody, all together sing along. La 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 la. So what's to lose? Let's spread the news. Don't refuse now, everybody, all together sing along. The melody, it holds the key to harmony, and all you have to sing is simply la la la. And pretty soon they'll hear the tune across the room, and out the window let the world hear la la la. Then join your hands across the land, strike up the band, and who's to say the whole wide world might sing along. So what's to lose? Let's spread the news. Don't refuse now, everybody, all together sing along. La 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 la
I wrote a song, Bobby Goldsborough there. I don't know if you remember, Jean. I'm sure you do, in fact. We had one of those set billings in the Radio Times that used to run from London, the tunes you've asked us to play, from Germany, the tunes that make them think of you.
I don't remember that,
those days
actually.
Are gone. Yeah, I'm looking at an old billing, actually, in front of me. I thought it was going to be one of those sentimental occasions and the sort of free-issue hankies and things.
You've done your homework, haven't you?
Well, Bobby Goldsborough and I wrote a song. So did Henry Mancini, of course, and he called it Moon River. And I've got Andy Williams in Belfast this afternoon to sing it, but not before I call up one or two people with the good news. So first, the Williamson family living in Dortmund. WO2 Bob Williamson with 159 Battery, 26 Field Regiment Royal Artillery is thinking of you all this afternoon. And that's you, Mum, and the children, June, Karen, Mark and Lorraine. Dad says, incidentally, happy birthday for Friday, Karen. Loved you all, and he'll be home later on this month. Well, now, here's a birthday tomorrow, and it belongs to Mrs. Rosemary Slade in Soest in Germany. Many happy returns, Rosemary. Stuart sends all his love. Says, could I please tell you he misses you very much, and he's counting the days till the end of the month when he'll be home with you in Germany. And Stuart is, of course, Sergeant Stuart Slade with 660 Squadron Army Air Corps. And finally, P. Martin is looking for the end of November, when he'll be home again with you, Pamela. So in the meantime, keep smiling as we spin for your delight, Andy Williams, Moon River.
Moon River, wider than a mile, I'm crossing you in style someday. You heartbreaker, wherever you're going, I'm going your way. Two drifters off to see the world, there's such a lot of world to see. We're after the same rainbow's end, waiting round the bend, my huckleberry friend. Wherever you're going, I'm going your way. Two drifters off to see the world, there's such a lot of world to see. We're after that same. My huckleberry friend, Moon River, and me.
Well, with my next card, this is for Gunner Stuart McFadden in Belfast. Hello, Stuart. And it's a record to remind you, it says, of your days at Woolwich as a recruit and a plonk. I don't know what a plonk is.
A bottle of wine.
But it sounds a bit like it, doesn't it? Anyway, it's when you were a recruit and a plonk with drill under the regimental sergeant major. And it comes from the plonks of January 75, so that's only going back a few months. But anyway, that's memories for you, Stuart. Hope you're listening.
And Mrs. Julia Lawler went out and bought the biggest postcard she could find in Amesbury. I bet she went to Salisbury and got it. It's a picture of the Salisbury Cathedral West Front, which is, what, 404 feet high. So it's got to be the biggest card and the biggest front of any English church. It's her husband's birthday today. This very day, she says, and her husband is Gunner Peter Lawler, who's serving with 26th Field Regiment in Belfast. Wish him a very happy birthday from all our family and friends. And we join in too. Happy birthday to you from us.
And my card is one from the lovely town of Totnes in Devon. Mum and Dad Castles live in a little village not far from Torquay, and their daughter and son-in-law and family are in Germany. Sergeant Keith Smith and wife Eileen and the children Tracy and Diane, and Keith is with 225 Signal Squadron in BFP 033. Love to you all from Mum and Dad Castles and Peter and Pat and their families, and greetings to all the friends that Mum and Dad made while they were on holiday in Germany this year. And I think the request for the song was on the card you had, Jean.
Yes, it's one of those tracks from Bill Oddie's LP, and this one is the one called Square Bashing Dance.
Squad! Squad! Shun! Squad! Shoulder! Arms! Keep them backs as stiff as starch! Squad! Wait for it! Quick! March! Lift right, lift right, turn about! Chin's right in and chest right out! Turn to left and round the square! Polish your boots and cut your hair! Up, two, three, four, up, two, three! If you know what to do, just watch me! Let's see you march, I know you can! March, you horrible little man! Now form up now in ranks of two! Wake up, Perkins, that means you! Now we're gonna have a special thrill! It's time for our own combat drill! Get your partner on the deck, tie his arms behind his neck, twist his foot and bend his toes, tweak his ear and punch his nose. It's all good fun, not too much pain. Now back in the line and march again. Squad, a present, a jugs. Squad, blowing by numbers, a blow.
He's done. Anyway, I think I'm right in saying, Jean, that all except yourself, we've all done our square bashing in our time.
We have our own version, you know.
Saturday afternoon cleaning up or something like
that's
that.
That's it, yes, exactly.
Right, I'm sure that in our time we've received lots of kisses from people who write in on the programme for a request, and Carol Muir is no exception. She's dropped me a line from BFP037, which rejoices in the name of Munsterlager here in Germany. She says she'd be forever in my debt if I mention her on the programme. It's especially a request for her husband, Vince Muir, in Belfast, Northern Ireland, at the moment. Now, he celebrates his 24th birthday in 2 days' time. So I shan't be with him, but tell him, Andrew, I love and miss him and counting the days till November. I'd also like to mention my mum and dad, Mr and Mrs Buckley, Kim, Sean, Mandy of Pinewood Way, RAF Curlan in Wiltshire, and not forgetting my grands in Sleaford and Gosport, and all will be over the moon. They'll all be over the moon at hearing their names on the radio. Please be a darling and don't let me down. So, Carol Muir, your request coming up in a few moments. Now call on BFP 39 at HQ, One British Corps, to Mick and Sue Charlesworth and the children, Paul and Louise. They dropped me a line to say a request, please, for Mum and Dad Charlesworth in Hartford, Hertfordshire, Mum and Dad Macman in Newark, Nottinghamshire, and our brand new niece, whose name is Sandra. Please say we're looking forward to seeing everybody again when we return to the United Kingdom on posting in October. Please also bid a fond farewell to all our friends in Germany, especially all you folkies. Any record would do, but we'd like to hear the theme from the television film called The Oneidan Line. So here is the theme. It's played by the Vienna Philharmonic Orchestra. Thank you.
theme from the Oneiden line there, played by the Vienna Philharmonic Orchestra. In fact, the Oneiden line have been short of the odd ship over the last few days because we've had one of them here in Belfast. She got into trouble in bad weather off the county down coast, the Charlotte Roads, and was towed into harbour. So, there we are. We've got our own share in the Oneiden line now. You remember, Cliff, the small studio looking out over, what was the street called? The Gorschfachwahl or something?
That's right. One of the great things about doing two-way family favourites from Hamburg was that you could look at it on three sides. You could look out at the prison on one side.
That's right, yeah.
And see all the prisoners waving to their loved ones below. And on the other side was the pathological laboratory. And just at the back of the studio was a street of a thousand delights for all night.
Indeed.
And on the other side of the place, of course, there was the police station. So I always thought that we were in the very best place in Hamburg and the music halle. But where all those people who sat in that studio in before me, I mean, Chris Howland came after, but Jimmy Kingsbury was there, and Robin Boyle, and Derek Jones. And
Dennis Cuse.
So he was after me, and Bill Crozier, of course.
Yeah.
Yeah, we all shared that. Yeah. We had to play our own records in those days. They get it easy these days, people over here.
Well, it's birthdays and anniversaries, it seems, in abundance this afternoon. And Sapper Glyn Foote is with 3-9 Field Squadron Royal Engineers here in Northern Ireland, and his wife, Christine, has her birthday today in Osnabrück. So happy birthday, Christine, and love on your special day from Glyn. To include, of course, daughter Tracy. And Glyn says he'll shortly be home for good. Well, what nicer birthday message could you wish for? Happy first anniversary to you this afternoon, Mrs. Patricia Hutchinson in County Durham. Your husband David, with LADREME, writes to us to say that having missed the first anniversary, he can only hope that you'll be together for the next 60 or so. Well, we've made 30. I don't see why you shouldn't make the 60. We hope so anyway. Congratulations to you both. Mrs. Anna Clements in Munster, I know that you're looking forward to Paul's next spell of R&R, which is coming up shortly. And I know that because Paul, Sergeant Paul Clements, has written to us to ask us to forward his love to you and his best wishes to all relations in Leicestershire and Manchester. And the record, I think, just about sums up the feelings of all those serving away from home for the particular person they leave behind. Jack Jones, Without Her.
I spend the night in the chair thinking she'll be there, but she never comes. And then I wake up, wipe the sleep from my eyes, and rise to face another day without her. It's just no good anymore when you walk through the door of an empty room, and then you go inside and set a table for one. It's no fun to spend another day without her. We burst the pretty balloon, it took us to the moon. Such a beautiful thing, but it's ended now. And it sounds like a lie if I say I'd rather die than spend another day without her. Love is a beautiful thing when it knows how to swing, and it grooves like a clock. But the hands on the clock till the lovers depart, it's breaking my heart to spend another day without her. I spend the night in the chair thinking she'll be there, but she never comes. And then I wake up, wipe the sleep from my eyes, and I rise to face another day without her. Can't go on without her. It's all wrong without her. Can't go on without her.
Gorgeous Jack Jones, Without Her. And now we're calling a young man called driver Colin Doherty, who had his birthday last Friday. Happy returns to you, Colin. Not from me, of course, but from your girlfriend, Gwyneth McLaughlin, in Whitchurch in Hampshire. That's in the flat bit outside Salisbury, I'm told. Anyway, lots of love to you, Colin. And Gwyneth wanted a record of any record of Gladys Knight and the Pips, and I think that's what we've got, haven't we, Sandy?
Indeed, and naming the song that they're going to sing is Mrs. Doreen Beresford of Crossland Road, Northfield, Birmingham, whose son, SAC Keith Beresford of RAF Laarbrook in Germany, is 9 years younger than family favourites because he's 21 today. Congratulations, Keith. Love from Mum and Dad, and Paul and Jeanette are looking forward to seeing you home at Christmas. And they've asked for this song, You're the Best Thing That Ever Happened to Me.
Gladys Knight and the Pips, and You're the Best Thing That Ever Happened to Me. Cliff, you mentioned Broadcasting House at the Musikhalle in Hamburg, and by one of those very strange quirks of fate, I heard a programme introduced by David Jacobs called Melodies for You, and very oddly they played Moonlight on the Ulster, which of course used to be Ariel's signature tune.
That's right, that's right.
For those BFM.
Swinging violins.
How they, in fact, waltzed on a lake, of course, I don't really know. And, of course, BFN changed its title to BFBS because people accused us of broadcasting for nothing, and then we became the British and Foreign Bible Service, and now we've gone back to BFN again. Let's get on with the cards, then. This one comes from Mrs. Tess Dudley of BFPO29, and her husband serves with 5-4 Squadron RCT BFPO29. Well, Mike would normally be in Germany, but at the moment he's in Northern Ireland. And the message is, it's not long, Mike, until the 26th of October. We all miss you a great deal. And by we, I mean myself, Tess, and the three children, Mark, Alison and Marie, and we all live in Minden. Can you also give our love to Ivy Chapman in Colchester? That's my mum, by the way, Andrew. Right, on to the next card from Corporal Mrs. Fryer of HQ Regiment, 1 British Corps, BFPO 39. And to this next request, it's for Mum and Dad, that's Ince and Alf Parker of Church Warsop Mansfield in Nottinghamshire. It was Iris's birthday on the 30th September, and also Brother David's on the 20th of September. So please send them all our love. Please also include a special mention for Adam Parker and Mum and Dad, that's Bill and Dot, of Canterbury in Kent. Also Fred and Jackie Boyle and their daughter Emma of Chatham in Kent and other friends and relatives who are probably listening to the programme. I jolly well hope they are. Sue and Pete Fryer, because your record's coming up right now. You asked for this number from the Stylistics. The title, Can't Give You Anything But Love.
Cliff and Jean, the basic sentiments haven't changed much over the years, have they? Good old family favourites titles. I can't give you anything but love.
I was thinking, actually, that that used to be a very old one on the other side. It used to be Chloe, wasn't it?
Chloe?
I can't give you anything but love.
Oh. Well, a nice sentiment anyway. And one that's coming your way this afternoon, Mrs. Moni Singh and daughter Harjita, living in Osnabrück. Your husband, with 17 Squadron Royal Corps of Transport, sends you both all his love and best wishes, looking forward to November, when you'll all be together again. Sergeant Instructor Ted Gracie is with the Army Physical Training Corps in Northern Ireland. This next card is for Ted, asking me to call up them from Ted, asking me to call up the missus. That's you, Francis, and the children Jason and Michelle, BFPO 17. Francis, Ted says he's missing you like mad, he says, and I quote, hopes you had a good leave in England, and adds, keep the letters coming. I'm sure you don't need that reminder. Anyway, I'm delighted to see you'll be together again at the end of this month. Well, 26 Field Regiment, Royal Artillery, have a married patch in Dortmund. Leastways, I assume they have, because that's where Mrs. Rita Dooley and children Mark, David and Derek live. The only person missing is Dad. That's Lance Bombardier Davy Dooley, because he's here in Northern Ireland. Anyway, he's remembering you all this afternoon. He sends you his love and Elvis Presley's Love Me Tender.
Love me tender, love me sweet, never let me go. You have made my life complete, and I love you so. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will. Love me tender, love me long, take me to your heart. For it's there that I belong, and will never part. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will. Love me tender, love me dear, tell me you are mine. I'll be yours through all the years, till the end of time. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will.
Love me tender. Now, how about one of your requests, Cliff?
Well, I only hope that Alan Aldred is not a football fan, because he comes from Colchester and they're not doing very well this year. Anyway, you're doing all right because you have a record which comes to you. Alan Aldred, who's in the 3rd Battalion, the Royal Regiment of Fusiliers, stationed in Dungannon. This comes from your wife, Jill, your children in Colchester. They can't wait until December the 15th.
It looks like a Christmas get-together for the Corbyn family at Curley Road, Oakdale Pool in Dorset. Mum has written to say, play a Wombles record, please, for my grandson Peter's 9th birthday in a few days' time, the 15th of October. He's with Mum and Dad, Sergeant and Mrs. P. Beaumont, and his two brothers in Germany. Army Catering Corps attached to 657 Army Air Corps in BFPO 37. Many happy returns, Peter, from Nan and Grandad and all the family. They're looking forward to Christmas and to little Perry's 4th birthday in January, because you're coming over to celebrate with them. And the music from the Wombles is Wombles on Parade.
A thousand miles away from rock and roll. the saxes of the band. The sound is all around, and it's nonsense to suggest that Alexander's was the best band in the land. When you hear the euphonium, you can't forget that it's just as like dancing if you keep in step. The mass band is competing on the corner. The music is waiting to be played. Come on along, get your feet moving. The wobbles are on parade. The top brass are saluting to the colors. The ladies are reclining in the shade. Come on along, get your boots on. The wobbles are on parade. Discipline is good for the soul. It's a thousand miles away from rock and roll. The mass band is convening on the corner. The music is waiting to be played. Come on along, get your feet moving. The wobbles are on parade. The top brass are saluting to the colors. The ladies are reclining in the shade.
Stand by your beds for the Wombles on Parade. I think we've got now what we ought to call our 30th birthday bumper bundle, because Andrew and Michael are joining forces with their requests for a Roger Whittaker record. Andrew?
Well, I have a nice line in Persuasion here from Janet Bridger of Dortmund. She writes, "If this card you do not read, beware a spell upon you I shall put. Oh. Which I am, say, please take heed, or be ready, I say, to be covered in soot. Once again, I do plead, pay this request for lonely me. If you don't, I shall cry. So please, 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 let me succeed." Actually, Janet, you're a rotten poet, and I'm sure you know it. Right, on to your link. It's for my parents in Aldershot, all family and friends listening, and also my husband, Doug Bridge, Bridger in Northern Ireland, with 2/6 Field Regiment, Royal Artillery. Janet, you're great fun. Thank you very much for your card. And over to you in Northern Ireland now, Michael.
Thank you very much, Andrew. Well, let me wind up the bumper bundle. Roger Whittaker's last farewell. Would you believe, what better record could we possibly have? Right, Lance Corporal Jeff Gainford is with 39 Field Squadron Royal Engineers, and he has his family living in Osnabrück. But it's not Nog now, fortunately, before they're all together again. For good, he says, underlined. Well, that must surely be cheering news for you, Mrs. Carol Gainford, and children Jeffrey Jr. and Gina. Well, it won't be long now, Carol, but in the meantime, says Jeff Sr., give those two beautiful children of ours a big kiss from Daddy. So get on with it, Carol. Well, I call are Mr. and Mrs. Roberts and Brother Ken in Lancashire. There's a card here from Bombardier Derek Roberts with Headquarter Battery 2/6 Field Regiment. He says, please give my love to Mum and Dad and me Brother Ken, also me sister Brenda and brother-in-law Brian in Middlesex. And please be sure, says Derek, to mention my darling niece Jackie.
Now, Mike, I was going to say I have one more here, if you'd like me to put one in.
Bang it in.
Right, it's on your link with Northern Ireland, a mention for Mike Dudley. He's serving there at the moment. The message is not long until the 26th of October. We all miss him, and we means Tess, his wife, and the children. Please give all our best wishes to our friends in Colchester. This comes from Tess, who's with BFPO, MBFPO 29, with 5-4 Squadron Royal Corps of Transport. That's him.
Okay, and if there's a Miss Elizabeth Purvis listening to her trammy this afternoon, she can only be tuned to family favourites, of course. So, Elizabeth, it's love from Corporal N. Denton. Sorry I don't have a Christian name there, but he's with the 2nd Royal, watch it, Andrew, Anglians. Right, here's Roger Whittaker, and would you believe, the last farewell.
Thank you. There's a ship lies rigged and ready in the harbor. Tomorrow for old England, she sails. Far away from your land of endless sunshine, to my land full of rainy skies and gales. And I shall be aboard that ship tomorrow, though my heart is full of tears at this farewell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell. I heard there's a wicked war a-blazing, and the taste of war I know so very well. Even now I see the foreign flag a-raising, their guns on fire as we sail into hell. I have no fear of death, it brings no sorrow, but how bitter will be this last farewell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell. Though death and darkness gather all about me, and my ship be torn apart upon the sea, I shall smell again the fragrance of these islands, in the heaving waves that brought me once to thee. And should I return safe home again to England, I shall watch the English mist roll through the dell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell.
Roger Whittaker and The Last Farewell, our bumper bundle song for today. Delighted to be able to say Jean was admitting just now that bumper bundle was her very own invention.
My contribution to Western culture. Can I squeeze one last mention in, Sandy, before we pack up? It's a mention for my husband. It says here, Sergeant Tom Hughes, who is at present out there in Northern Ireland. And I'm to tell you, Tom, from your wife Alex and your little daughter Debbie, who posted the card in Bedfordshire, that they love and miss you very much. Couldn't bear to see it wasted.
No, and I felt the same about this one. Just to mention the 21st birthday last Thursday of Lance Corporal Philip Newbury of REME Workshops, attached to 8th Regiment RCT in BFPO 17. Love to you and your wife Jenny from Gran Newbury of Whitway Road. I think the next word is Newton, but I'm not sure. Anyway, it's in Gloucestershire. Many happy returns. And I'm afraid we come to the end of our hour, very nearly. Andrew and Michael, of course, many thanks, and we'll be getting together again in 3 weeks' time. And I'm sure you will want to say thank you and goodbye to Jean and Cliff.
Yes, in fact, if I say, I'm sorry, Cliff, that we've kept you. It's going to be a cold lunch today, isn't it, I'm afraid?
No, hot. Our daughter's cooking it.
Well, I've got a trident to catch back to Manchester in a few moments. In your day, it was probably through the hook, was it?
That's right.
So I'll say goodbye from Germany, and the message is, as always, from Germany and Berlin. Take care of yourselves, because we'll be doing exactly the same here in Germany. Bye-bye for now, and thank you very much indeed, Jean and Cliff.
Bye-bye, Andrew. Bye-bye. And Michael.
Thank you very much. It was lovely to meet you once again, Jean, and, in fact, to chat with Cliff. Nice to meet you both. I've thoroughly enjoyed today's programme. Thank you.
Okay, and Jean and Cliff, belated congratulations to you two on your silver wedding anniversary. Here's to the next 25 years and the next 30 years of family favourites.